Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am so excited to be doing this video. I've been planning on making this video for a very, very long time. I just wanted to put it together in a way that was informative and not pushy. I really want to use my social media platforms for a lot more than just talking about fashion and beauty and all those things. As much as I love those things, I think there are so many other things that are going on in our planet that are so, so important, and I wanted to raise awareness about it. So I thought that today's video was really, really important. And if you are watching this and you're searching for ways to better our planet and to be more sustainable, I'm going to be sharing with you some easy ways that you can do that, because I know that the transition into sustainability is not the easiest thing. You have to take baby steps to get there. And I also want to put it out there that I am not perfect. I don't want to sound like I am preaching. I'm just simply sharing the tips and tricks that I picked up along my own journey of trying to become more sustainable, and I wanted to share it with you guys. So I really hope that you will find this a video helpful and informative, and maybe it will inspire you to make little changes here and there in your own life. And I'm also so excited that I'm able to partner with an amazing brand for this video, SandCloud. They are sponsoring this video. They were actually on one of my absolute favorite shows, Shark Tank.
Towels, since their inception, are inherently plain.
I'm out.
Let's bring it back to the beginning. 4 years ago, during a board meeting, we had an idea. We started SandCloud, a brand dedicated to making a difference in the world by protecting our oceans and marine life.
They make products that are 100% sustainable, and 10% of all profits go to marine conservation, which is so amazing and so cool. So if you guys are looking for some sustainable products that you want to add into your life or replace some non-sustainable products that you already have in your life for more sustainable ones, I think SandCloud is such an amazing company to go to for that. SandCloud was also so kind to offer my subscribers a 20% off discount code on everything on their website using the code NIKKI20. So if you guys are interested in checking out anything on their website, I'm going to link their website across the screen here and also link it in my description box down below. So make sure to check it out. Without further ado, let's hop into the video. So the first thing that I personally started to do when I started my journey of becoming more sustainable is try to decrease my overall consumption of single-use plastic. So what I mean by that is single-use plastic bags that I would get at the grocery store, plastic cups, plastic utensils, plastic straws. Now, I know that in certain situations, it's really, really difficult to do that. One of the ways that I have been trying to decrease my consumption is by carrying one of these in my bag at all times. So what this is a little pouch that contains a metal straw and also a cleaner for your metal straw. These are from SandCloud. I have three of them. So anytime I go to a coffee shop and I'm craving a nice drink, but the coffee shop doesn't have an alternative for plastic straws, I will whip this out of my bag and just use my metal straw. They're super easy to clean. They don't take up a lot of space in your purse. So they're such an easy thing that you can incorporate into your daily routine. Another change that I have been trying to make is to really pay attention to the materials that I am purchasing. I always try to purchase sustainable materials, materials that are recycled. And one of the changes I started to make was to swap out all of my beach towels. And I've been swapping them out from these beautiful tie-dye beach towels from SandCloud. They are made out of 100% recycled materials. They're super soft, made out of amazing material. And I also like that these double as like a beach cover-up or a sarong if you wanted to. They're super nice. I'd highly recommend checking them out. I have them in my little beach bag right now because I was just using them the other day at the pool. I think they are beautiful. And again, 10% of all profits from SandCloud go to marine conservation. So it's a great cause to support. So one of the things that I have been doing for several years, and you guys may know this if you've been following me for a while, is that I like to resell my old clothing through different places like Depop, consignment stores. I also donate a lot of my old clothing, and that way my old clothing can be reused by someone else. Someone else can enjoy it as much as I used families do enjoy it, and you're not contributing to the whole textile garbage issue that we have going on. So if you do have some old clothing, instead of throwing it out, I would suggest looking into donating or selling it, because those are some great ways to kind of recycle your clothing. And if you guys are interested in checking out my Depop account, I'm gonna link it across the screen here and also in my description box. Another thing that I have been doing for a long time, especially recently, I've been doing it a lot more to minimize the amount of new clothing that I buy, is to shop pre-loved. I love vintage shopping. I love going to luxury consignment stores and seeing what kind of gems I can find. I think it is a super fun way to kind of browse around and find pieces that you normally would not find anywhere else. You can find pieces that are super unique, that are incredible quality, and pieces that will be in your wardrobe for years and years. So if you haven't tried it yet, definitely try out vintage shopping. It's so much fun. And when you do find a gem that you're obsessed with, it's like such an incredible feeling. Another thing I wanted to talk about is something that I don't understand why it's not more obvious to a lot more people. I was in the same boat. Whenever I go grocery shopping, for whatever reason, I'm just preconditioned to put all of my produce into plastic bags. Even if I was taking like one lemon or one avocado, I would put that one lemon or one avocado into a single-use plastic bag. Now that I think about it, it is so wasteful. And to be honest, most produce does not have to come in plastic bags. So now whenever I can, I just carry all of my produce the way that it is without any plastic bags. I like to call it naked fruit or naked vegetables. So if I'm grabbing some lemons or tomatoes or avocados or whatever it may be, I just throw it into my reusable grocery shopping bag and I don't even use the plastic bags. Now, obviously, there are certain fruits and vegetables that are really difficult to keep all of your produce together. For example, if it's something that is smaller, like blueberries or cherries that you have to grab by hand, then obviously I would recommend using a bag, but you can still avoid using a plastic bag. If you go on Amazon and you just type in reusable grocery bag or whatever, you're gonna find so many amazing options. So all you have to do is just throw them into your bag before you go to the grocery store and just fill them up as you go. Another thing I like to do when I go grocery shopping is to bring my own grocery shopping bags, reusable grocery shopping bags. If I remember, I usually keep them in my car so that I won't forget. And that way you don't have to waste more grocery bags than you need to, and you can really reduce your overall plastic consumption. Another thing that I started doing, especially when I go clothing shopping now, is I always ask for a paper bag over a plastic bag. Now, sometimes some retailers don't have the option of paper over plastic. They only have plastic, in which case I try to bring my own reusable shopping bag with me when I go shopping. It doesn't always happen. I don't always remember to do it, but that's another good idea if you really want to minimize your use of plastic. You can just keep the reusable shopping bag in your car like you do with your reusable grocery shopping bags, and anytime you go to a mall or whatever it may be, you can just bring your shopping bag with you. Next, I want to talk about something that may be a sensitive subject to some, but again, I just want to put it out there. I am not judging. I'm also not perfect when it comes to this front, but I wanted to talk about decreasing the amount of meat that we consume. Now, meat is actually one of the most contributing factors to global warming, to pollution, to negative environmental changes. So I would really suggest doing more in-depth research about it. Now, in my home, I know that my husband and I, we still consume meat, but we consume way less meat than we used to. And we also make sure that the meat that we do consume and buy is ethically sourced, that it is hormone-free, antibiotic-free, it's organic, it's free-run, and it's raised in a very ethical way. Now, I know to a lot of people, it may not be as good as cutting it out completely, but for us, it is a staple in our diet. So because we have reduced it so dramatically, I feel like we are doing the best job that we can right now. Maybe one day we will get to a point where we'll be able to cut it out completely, but for now, we're just trying to do the best that we can. Again, I want to really reiterate, I'm not perfect. I don't expect anyone else to be perfect. As long as we are all doing our best to make small changes wherever we can, I think we can make such a huge difference. It's gonna go a much farther way if a lot of people are making small changes versus only a few people being absolutely perfect about everything. So it's just about raising awareness and thinking about your actions and just trying to make little changes here and there that will better our planet. Now, probably the easiest thing that you can possibly do is to always throw out your trash. I cannot stand when people just leave their trash laying on the ground or on the grass or whatever it may be. Always pick up your trash, throw it out, recycle it if it's recyclable. If you see trash next to you, pick it up, throw it out. It's the easiest thing that you can do and it can honestly go such a long way. Speaking of picking up trash, you can join a ton of different organizations or groups and do like a group pickup on the beach, at a park, or wherever it is that these groups take place. Not only does it help raise awareness about picking up trash and throwing out trash, but it will also make such a big difference in the area that you helped clean up. You can easily Google a ton of these groups. You can also check them out on Facebook. I also think it's a great activity to do with kids because you can raise awareness from a very young age and educate them about how important it is to not only throw away trash, but pick it up and tell them about all of the repercussions of trash on the environment if you just leave it hanging around. Another recent swap that I made in my life was swapping out my toothbrush. Now, we don't think about this, but toothbrushes are made out of plastic and they usually last about 3 months, or at least they should last 3 months. You should be replacing your toothbrush every 3 months because it harbors bacteria and all of that, and it's not very hygienic to use it for longer than that. So a more sustainable alternative to that are bamboo toothbrushes. This is a set of two bamboo toothbrushes that is also from SoundCloud. My other one is currently in my bathroom because I am using it, so I wanted to show you my spare one. So bamboo is actually one of the most sustainable materials in the world. So if you can find products that are made out of bamboo, it is so much better than plastic or anything else that you can use. It's also a very sturdy and resilient material, and bamboo is 100% biodegradable, whereas plastic, as I've already mentioned, it doesn't degrade. It survives in our landfills for eternity. So again, if you guys are interested in checking out SoundCloud, check my description box down below, and 10% of profits go to marine conservation. Another easy swap that you can do in your daily beauty routine is just to replace your plastic hairbrush for a bamboo or a wooden hairbrush. I actually find that bamboo and wooden hairbrushes work so much better. You guys know how much I love my wet brush, but that is one of the things that I am trying to change. They're also very affordable, pretty accessible, and I feel like they're so much easier to clean than the plastic hairbrushes. Another thing that I'm trying to do more of is to support more sustainable fashion brands when I am shopping for clothes. And not only shopping more for more sustainable fashion brands, but also thinking about the clothing that I'm buying and making more conscious decisions. I'm thinking about longevity, if it's something that I can mix in into my wardrobe really easily and wear with a ton of different pieces and outfits. Overall, I just feel like I'm becoming more of a conscious shopper, and that is the goal of this video. I just want you guys to become more conscious. It's not all about doing everything right. I still go to Zara every once in a while, although I go way less. But if I do go to Zara, I try to look for pieces that are made from natural materials, and I'm trying to invest more into pieces that are more sustainable, from sustainable brands. I try to look for high quality fabrics, and I stopped buying things that I know I'm only going to wear once. In 2019, I can honestly say that we are so lucky to have all of these options of amazing sustainable brands and designers. And I feel like over the years, they're just going to become more and more accessible as long as we vote for those things with our dollars. So the more you're going to be supporting sustainable brands and sustainable designers, the more we are going to see them in malls and the more accessible they will be. And lastly, this is probably the most important point that I wanted to talk about, and that is to swap all plastic water bottles. Water bottles are probably one of the biggest wastes of plastic. I'm still in shock that a lot of people drink from plastic water bottles, and it's such an easy thing just to eliminate completely. So in our house, my husband and I actually installed a filter that's right over our sink. We've had it for years already. So what we do is just invest in reusable bottles like this glass bottle. This one is from SoundCloud, but we have a ton of other ones that are either glass or stainless steel, and we just fill them up from the filter over our sink, and we drink that throughout the day. If you're out of the house and you don't have your reusable water bottle on hand, luckily there are a couple of brands that make more sustainable water bottles that are recyclable. One of my favorite brands is Flo. There's another one that comes in like a white milk carton that you can recycle when you're done with it. So I would just be more conscious about it. So if you are out of the house and you are thirsty and you're looking for water, try to find the brands that make the water bottles that are recyclable instead of going for plastic. Now, I totally understand that not everyone is able to install an actual water filter into their sink. So in that case, what you can do is just get a Brita filter. It's a great way to filter tap water and be a lot more sustainable when it comes to your drinking water. And I promise you, it is such an easy thing to incorporate into your daily routine. Okay guys, so that wraps up today's video. I really hope that you enjoyed it. I really, really hope that this video inspired you, raised awareness about certain things that you may not have thought about before. Again, I don't want to sound like I'm preaching. I don't want to sound like I'm pushing anything on you or judging you in any way, because I'm not perfect myself. I just think that we could all do little things in our daily routine to make small improvements. And in the grand scheme of things, if a lot of us are making those little small improvements, we can make such a big difference for our planet. I want to thank SoundCloud again for sponsoring this video, and I highly suggest you guys check out their products because they are awesome. They have so many things that you can easily incorporate into your daily routine to kind of get you started. And again, I wanted to remind you about my 20% off discount code on their entire site using my code Nikki20. I'm going to link them down below. And as always, I want to thank you guys so much for watching and hanging out with me, and I will see you in my next one.